Hi guys, and welcome back. It's me, Jan, with another video. And I know, it passed quite some time since the last video, but I can tell you that we have been busy working on a lot of awesome stuff. Like this Townsman update. It's very huge. We made a lot of additions, changes, and generally there's a lot of awesome stuff for you guys to explore. And this is why we are doing this video. So here I will showcase some of the new stuff that we added to the game. So yes, let's stop the talking for the moment at least and jump into my map and have a look at all the new stuff. Yeah, with the update there are three new scenarios. It's Avalanche Risk, A Year of Festivities and Moneybags. We also added three new sandbox maps. It's Canyon, the Icy Hold and Big River. Alright, here we are in my city. As you can see, there's a lot of stuff happening. My townies are busy and I also have quite some buildings already on the map. Okay, so where do we start? Why don't we start with our adjusted production chains for brew and the juice manufacturer. Okay, so we added two new buildings to the production chain of these two items. One is the vineyard, or the vineyard, and the other one is the oast house. So, in previous iterations of the game, your monastery produced hops and brew at the same time. Now the monastery is only producing brew and it gets its resources, in that case it's hops, wheat and water, from the warehouse. And yeah, to produce hops you now need the oast house, and here your monks can then gather the resource from it. The same thing now applies for your juice manufacturer. You now have the vineyard with grapes, and there your grapes are collected. And afterwards, in the juice manufacturer, they can be produced to some juice. And yeah, we adjusted the whole thing for the infirmary as well. So let's have a look. Where's our infirmary? Oh, we don't have one yet, but that's no problem. Let's just build one. There it is. So we even have a quest for it. It's all right. Let's just use some prestige and there it is. Yeah, so in the infirmary you are no longer producing herbs. You have to gather them at your farmhouse. So now at the farm you can collect wheat, wool or herbs. And for that, yeah, just place your herb field maybe close to your farm and then your farmers can start collecting your herbs. And after this little cut we are back in my city. I speed up the gameplay here a little bit to show you the seasonal changes. Yes, we added some new seasons to the game, the missing ones, autumn and spring, and wow, look at that. Wow, a lot of stuff is going on. Okay, so it started to rain, there's a thunderstorm and people are celebrating. Okay, so that's great, yes, why not? So let's start with the fairground. Here you can see the fairground, one of our new entertainment buildings, where your townies can conduct festivities and have a lot of fun and enjoy themselves. The fairground raises your happiness temporarily for 20%. And yes, with the addition of our new entertainment buildings, we also reworked the entertainment satisfaction a little bit. You can see it in your statistics tab over here in the entertainment tab. Satisfaction with entertainment in town. It's now pretty straightforward. If you want to raise the entertainment satisfaction in the town, conduct festivities or build a juggler camp, for example, also a new building, or some contest grounds. Yes, at the contest grounds, your townsfolk or your hunters and soldiers can take part in some archery contests and enjoy your townies. The juggler is quite self-explanatory. He juggles around, spits some fire and is entertaining your townies as well. Oh wow, the new weather is really, really awesome. It's raining, there's a thunderstorm. It looks great. But our townies don't care. They are still having a great time. Oh, well, nope, it stopped. But that's no problem, you can even start a festival, at a fairground, whenever you want for some prestige. Great. Yes! New weather effects, huh? It stops raining now. They look great, they feel great, but you also have to be careful, because if there is a thunderstorm going around, lightning might strike some of your buildings and then a fire might start, so be careful. Also, with the addition of seasons, we added some meaningful changes to your the map influences. So, in autumn, for example, food consumption is increased by 25%, but the vineyard productivity is increased by 15%. Yeah, you have more rain, so your farm productivity is increased. Yeah, generally, the seasons mean there are influences on the map. So, in winter, we might have different influences than in summer. Alright, great! What else can I show you? Basically, why don't we continue with the seasons and the weather effects, and let's jump to a map where there's some snow and maybe some avalanches. Oh, look at that, a countdown, how convenient. 3, 2, 1. Ooh. Yep. Dramatic music. An avalanche. And your town is destroyed. Yeah, I would say that's quite one of the bigger features in the game now. So you have the avalanche risk, especially in winter or the winter maps, or in maps where you have some hills, like in this map, for example. So you have to be careful where you build your city and maybe spread it out a little, so if an avalanche strikes, not everything is destroyed. And with that, I can also show you another new and cool feature. When there are destroyed buildings, these signs now appear where you can easily rebuild a building directly at the spot where the sign is. You don't have to do much. If you especially have some prestige, it's very easy to rebuild your city. Great! Oh, wonderful timing! It's started to snow, so I can show you these awesome new weather effects in winter. Just let it sink in. Can you hear the wind whistling? The snowflakes on the screen? Great. Really, really great. Alright, after a lot of snow and avalanches, we are now back in my starting map. There's also a lot of snow, because we are now in winter, and there is another cool feature I can show you now, that the fairground is changing according to the season. So, in winter we have this Christmas tree over here, and if we start a festivity, we have different music, and it looks like that. Isn't it great? Alright, what else is there I can show you? Oof. We also made a lot of technical improvements to the game. We reworked the quest system and the sandbox mode. Yeah, but basically I think that should be it. That should cover the most changes to our game. And I would say now, why don't you enjoy it? Enjoy the update, have fun with it, and as always, guys, if you like this video, like and subscribe, and I will see you next time.